For a long time, man could not see that he had developed a very bad habit. Now we know better. Smoking tobacco is not only a bad habit, it is a deadly one. The challenge is clear. In the interests of health, we must work towards a society free of tobacco and free of the disease it causes. But this can only be done with a counterattack against a deeply ingrained habit and a huge money-making machine. It is a battle, however, that is being fought and won. Yes, the smoke of others can kill. It is estimated that each year in the United States, 5,000 deaths are caused by so-called passive or enforced smoking. Smokers' rights must end where the health of others begins. The signs of change are everywhere. Many governments and private enterprises have banned smoking in public places. Designated non-smoking areas are now commonplace. Setting an example, the World Health Organization is now a smoke-free workplace. More and more, smoking is being limited on public transportation, and on some airlines, smoking is now completely prohibited. Many governments require that cigarettes be labeled with a warning that they are dangerous. Not only has cigarette advertising been greatly restricted in a number of countries, in 20 countries, it has been banned completely. In the place of cigarette advertising, a different kind of advertising is appearing. Now the power of television is being used positively to inform and to educate. Watch.
It's time to clear the air. Come on, all you smokers, show us that you care.
It's Smoke-Free Week. If you're a smoker, try to give up. And if you're a non-smoker, give all the support you can. Smoke-Free Week's for all of us.
Talk to those still smoking. Show them that you care. Tell them that
enough's enough.
You want to clear the air.
No one reason we don't smoke. They get in the way of things.
It's like losing a hand. They're a handicap not just to your health,
but to your life.
Can you run with them, jump with them, swim with them, anything? I'd rather have time on my hands to do this.
Or this. Or do this. Smoking. Haven't you got anything better to do with your life?
Oh, darling.
I knew it was you.
What's that you're reading, Cap?
If you won't give up smoking for yourself, do it for your kids.
Toujours un garçon et une fille au désespoir.
Le tabac, c'est plus ça.
I don't think we can make a delivery before, let's say, two. Can you wait a second?
Help! Oh.
Tuesday, how does that suit you?
These messages are being heard. In some industrialized nations, smoking by men has dropped by as much as 40%. People are starting to stop. But unfortunately, not everywhere. In the third world, tobacco use is increasing by more than 2% every year. Lured by the bait of Western advertising and potential profits, these countries are being hooked by the tobacco pushers. Areas already beset by a myriad of traditional health problems will also be facing an epidemic of new lung cancer cases by the turn of the century. Only a global response can ensure a victory over tobacco. On April 7, 1988, its 40th birthday, the World Health Organization launched the world's first No Tobacco Day. It is a challenge to everyone.
Let us all join the fight for a society free of tobacco. There will be many partners in the fight, but I appeal particularly to the doctors, women and men of my profession. If you smoke, quit now. The least you can do is to set the example. To governments, you have passed many laws against many public health hazards. What about tobacco? The media, your power and influence are enormous. Use some of it in the fight against tobacco. The celebrities, millions and millions imitate you. Don't shirk your responsibility. The smokers, please do quit. If not for yourself, at least for those who love you.
Our health is priceless. Don't let tobacco steal it away. We must learn from the millions who have gambled and lost. Listen to actor Yul Brynner, who made this appeal shortly before he died of lung cancer.
I really wanted to make a commercial when I discovered that I was that sick and my time was so limited. I wanted to make that commercial that says simply, now that I'm gone, I tell you, don't smoke. Whatever you do, just don't smoke.
The message is simple. Tobacco or health? Choose health.